assessment one quiz. Okay, so for quiz, you have three questions. Okay, so include for topic one until topic three. Okay, so for first question, okay, so the manager of a beverage company wishes to estimate the average time for an operator to complete a particular job. So the company has a 7 department and 10 operators selected at random from each department, and their time to complete a particular job is recorded. So in this case, the question asks you what is the population and sample of this study. Okay, so if the question asks you on population and also sample, so make sure you write what is your population and then what is your sample. Okay, jangan terus buat je. Okay, first line population, second line sample. Tapi you tak mention yang mana satu. Okay, make sure you tulis dulu lah what is your population and then what is your sample. So in this case, so macam biasa, for population, the keyword is all. Okay, you need to have all. Okay, so you tulis. Okay, population. So make sure you listkan this is your population and then your sample. Okay, so for population, make sure the keyword is all. Kena ada all. Okay, and then if the question give you a value, okay, you ada value, so bagi tahulah value. Tapi in this case, dia just kata the company has a 7 department and then 10 operators selected random from each department. So this is your sample. So dia tak ada bagi tahulah dalam company tu ada berapa banyak dia punya pekerja total, apa nama tu, semua pekerja dia. So you just cakap je all operators from 7 department of beverage company. So macam tu je lah dia punya jawapan. Okay, so make sure ada perkataan all. Okay, so all operator from 7 department. And then bagi tahulah company apa. So beverage company. So make sure you write the full sentence lah. Okay. So kalau you just buat all operator saja, so kat situ tak ada markah lah. Okay. So that is for the first population. And then for sample, so in this case, you kena hati-hati since this is the case for stratified sampling. So the question said that 10 operator are selected at random from each department. So 10 operator ni hanya untuk satu department. You have 7 department. So untuk sample, okay, so you akan kata whether you want to write 70 operator selected from 7 department beverage company, ataupun kalau you nak guna istilah each ni, so you cakap 10 operator are selected at random from each department. Mesti ada keyword each. So maksudnya 10 darab dengan 7. Since you have 7 department, so you ada 70 lah. Tapi if you just answer 10 operator selected from department, so maksudnya you kata hanya 10 orang sahaja. Okay, you tak mention each department, so there is no marks lah kat situ. Okay, so make sure sama ada you mention 70 operators ataupun you cakap 10 operator from each department. Okay, baru you boleh dapat one mark. Okay, so itu adalah untuk first questions. And then ingat kalau population dia mesti ada all keyword dia. Okay, kalau dia ada bagi value dia berapa, so mention value dia. Kalau tak ada, just mention je lah apa dia punya population. And then for sample, so berapa. So cuma untuk sample ni, you kena hati-hatilah if the case is stratified. Since 10 ni for each department, so you have 7 department, so dia ada 70. Okay, kalau you just cakap 10 operator selected, so wrong lah. Okay, you punya jawapan tu salah. Alright, and then for the second question, okay, the question asks you on the sampling technique. So we have 4 sampling technique, which is apa nama itu, simple random sampling ataupun systematic random sampling ataupun stratified sampling or cluster sampling. Okay, so untuk simple random sampling and systematic random sampling, dia tak ada masalah. Okay, since dua-dua ni tak ada group bila dia tak pecahkan kepada berapa department, dia just bagi tahu ada apa nama itu beverage company and then dia just pilih 100 daripada total semua tu. So itu adalah simple random sampling. Okay, kalau dia ada mention dia pilih for every, contohnya dia kata 7, okay, dia pilih apa nama tu sample tu from 7 apa nama itu, dia punya sampling interval dia, K dia ni. So bila ada nampak je macam ni, you tahu this is the systematic random sampling. Okay. Tapi untuk cluster and stratified, you kena hati-hati since untuk dua-dua case ni, you akan divide into groups, into strata. Okay. So how to differentiate between apa nama itu, stratified and cluster. So remember kalau nak differentiate dia, kalau untuk apa namanya itu, stratified, you akan pecahkan the strata into the same. Okay, maksudnya you akan pecahkan kepada group yang sama. Eh sorry, group yang berbeza tapi dalam tu semua sama. So macam mana nak bezakan stratified sampling and cluster sampling? So untuk stratified sampling, you akan pecahkan, okay, you akan pecahkan kepada different group. Okay, maksudnya between ni. Okay, so between group dia adalah hetero. Okay, contohnya kita ada color. Okay, so kita ada contohnya kita ada warna merah, kita ada warna hitam dengan kita ada color blue contohnya. So dekat dalam each strata ni, semua ni merah. Okay, dalam ni semua ni hitam, dalam ni semua ni biru. So within group dia adalah homo. Okay, semua ni sama. Okay, so untuk nak pilih sampel, so untuk nak pilih sampel, kita akan pilih from each group. So nak ambil sampel, sini kena ambil sikit, sini kena ambil sikit, sini kena ambil sikit. So keyword dia adalah each group. You divide into apa nama itu, a few group, a few strata, and then when you nak ambil sampel tu, you akan ambil from each group. Okay, berbeza dari segi cluster sampling. So untuk cluster sampling, you akan pecahkan, divide you punya strata tu into the same thing. Okay, maksudnya you punya between group tu dia adalah homo. Okay, contohnya kita nak kata apa nama itu, type of emergency. Okay, type of emergency dekat hospital. Kita ada red zone, kita ada green zone, and then kita ada yellow zone. Kita ada tiga zone. So dekat dalam ni, contohnya you ada male dengan female. Okay, you ada male dengan female. And then dekat dalam ni pun you ada male dengan female. Dalam ni pun you ada male dengan female. So within group, dia adalah hetero. Okay, dia berbeza. Okay, so kalau untuk stratified tadi, between group ni yang berbeza, dia ada merah, hitam, biru, tapi within group ni semua merah, semua hitam, semua biru. And then nak ambil sampel, kita kena ambil from each group. Tapi for cluster sampling, untuk kita punya sampel, kita hanya pilih all group. So maksudnya kalau you nak ambil red zone, semua yang dalam red zone ni, kalau ada 50 orang, semua 50 orang ni akan jadi you punya sampel. Okay, so you can choose whether you want to choose only one group ataupun you boleh ambil two group, you boleh ambil red zone and green zone. Okay, untuk jadi you punya sampel, tapi kena ambil all dekat dalam tu. Okay, kena ambil yang all ni. So kalau dalam dari 50 orang, semua tu kena ambil. Okay, tapi you tak boleh ambil all the groups. Kalau you ambil semua ni, dia dah tak jadi sampel lah, dia jadi population. Okay. So sama ada kalau contohnya you ada 3 group, so you can choose 1 group ataupun 2 group. Maximum is 2 group. Kalau you ada 5 group, so you boleh ambil maximum 4 group lah. You tak boleh ambil semua group. Kalau you ambil semua group, dia jadi population. Dia bukan jadi sample. Okay. So itu adalah beza certified dengan cluster. Okay. So dalam dalam kes yang ni, so dia adalah certified sampling. Since you ada apa namanya tu, 7 department. And then you pilih setiap satu department tu untuk jadi sampel. Okay. So dia punya sampling teknik dia adalah stratified. And then give a reason. So kenapa? Sebab kita kata because 10 operator are selected at random from each department. So this is the keyword untuk stratified. Okay. So stratified sampling technique 1 mark. And then reason you 1 mark. And then the last one, identify the variable of interest and then hint state the type of variable, level of measurement and the most appropriate graphical presentation. So dia ada 4 benda lah kat situ. So untuk nak jawab soalan macam ni, make sure you listkan satu-satu. Okay, you bagi tahu variable apa, type of variable apa, level of measurement apa, graphical presentation dia apa. Okay, So dalam kes yang ini, kita tahu dia nak estimate the average time for an operator to complete a particular job. So untuk variable, you just salin daripada average time je, bukannya yang to estimate. Kalau you salin daripada to estimate, dia jadi wrong lah. That is not your variable. Ini dah jadi you punya objective. Okay, so make sure bila you write you punya variable tu hanya ambil variable apa je yang dia nak study. So kita just nak tengok on the average time. Okay, so this is your variable. So this is your variable, and then what is the type of variable? So dia adalah quantitative continuous variable. Okay, sebab dia melibatkan masa. You boleh count, you boleh measure. Okay, dia adalah quantitative continuous variable, and then dia punya level of measurement. So untuk quantitative, so you kena ingat kita ada dua, kita ada qualitative and quantitative. So untuk qualitative kita hanya ada dua sahaja. Okay, sama ada nominal or ordinal. Okay, and then for quantitative sama ada dia ratio or interval. So macam mana nak bezakan antara dua tu, you kena tengoklah. Kalau case dia adalah qualitative, so qualitative ni adalah variable tu dalam bentuk kategorical, tak melibatkan nombor. Okay, dalam bentuk kategori, and then untuk quantitative ni adalah dalam bentuk numerical, dalam bentuk nombor. So untuk level of measurement, untuk kategori kita hanya ada nominal ataupun ordinal. Okay, so kalau contohnya variable you adalah gender, so kita tahu gender is qualitative variable. So dia punya level of measurement dia sama ada nominal ataupun ordinal. Tak boleh tiba-tiba you kata dia punya level of measurement is interval. Dah salah lah. Since gender ni dia adalah qualitative variable. So sama ada nominal ataupun ordinal saja. Okay, kalau contohnya you ada apa namanya tu age. Okay, so kalau age, so sama ada interval ataupun ratio saja. Tak boleh tiba-tiba jadi ordinal ke nominal. Melainkan age tu you buat dalam bentuk kategori. Contohnya you buat dari 20 sampai 25, dari 26 sampai 30. So bila dah jadi kategori macam ni, yang itu barulah dia jadi ordinal. Okay, tapi kalau age tu yang memang isi tempat kosong, so dia adalah quantitative variable, so sama ada interval ataupun ratio macam tu. Okay, so make sure you hati-hati untuk apa namanya tu, untuk yang ni lah. Okay, make sure you boleh tahu macam mana nak tentukan variable, macam mana nak tahu dia punya type of variable, sama ada qualitative or quantitative, and then macam mana nak tahu dia punya level of measurement, okay, and then dia punya appropriate graphical presentation. So yang ini since dia adalah quantitative continuous variable, so dia adalah ratio lah. Okay, so time ni the ratio. And then untuk graphical presentation, so kita tahu untuk topik tu kita pecah dua, quantitative and qualitative. So kalau quantitative sama ada kita nak guna apa, stem and leaf plot, histogram ataupun box and whisker plot. Tapi kalau dia qualitative, dia boleh guna pie chart, bar chart, okay, frequency distribution ataupun cross tabulation. So dalam case ni since dia adalah quantitative, so you punya answer hanya boleh ni je lah. Okay, kalau you buat bar chart ke pie chart ke, salah lah you punya jawapan since the case is quantitative variable. Okay, so itu adalah untuk first question, question one. Okay, so now kita tengok on question two. Okay, so for question 2, this is question for descriptive statistic topic 2. Okay, so dia dah bagi dekat you apa nama itu, admission price. Okay, for 13 theme park. So you punya N is 13. Okay, so dah bagi dekat you data selected at random. So ini hanyalah sample sahaja. So dia dah bagi dekat you descriptive statistic table. So you ada you punya N, you ada you punya mean. So this is your X bar. And then you ada you punya median, okay, you punya Q2, and then you ada you punya mode, and then you ada standard deviation, you ada percentile. So percentile ni adalah untuk you punya Q1 and Q3. So you dah ada Q1, you ada Q2, you ada Q3. So kalau dalam kes yang ini, okay, dia suruh find the value of A and B, you punya mean and also mode. So yang ni you just guna formula je lah untuk mean. So make sure you show how you get the value for your mean. Okay, guna yang X bar is equal to summation of X over N. Okay. Okay, guna yang ni lah. Guna formula ni. Since dia adalah untuk sample, so X bar lah. Okay, so just kira. Okay, so make sure you show. And then, jangan lupa unit dia RM. Okay. And then untuk mode, so untuk mode adalah frekuensi yang paling tinggi, kekerapan yang paling tinggi. So dalam kes ni you ada tengok 50 ada 2 kali. And also you ada 65. So you ada 2 lah mode you. Okay, RN50 and also RN65. Okay. So nak selamat kalau melibatkan duit ni, you letak je unit dia. Okay. So itu adalah untuk the first question. And then the second one, what is the first quartile? Interpret the first quartile. So your first quartile is this one. Okay, so this is the value RM44. So macam mana nak interpret dia? So nak interpret dia, you refer yang the last slide ni, yang position ni. Okay, so untuk first quartile, kita akan kata 25% less and then 75% more. Okay, so dekat sini, dalam kes ni, kita akan kata 25% of the starting admission price is less than RM42. And then 75% lagi more than RM42. So yang ni jangan terbalik lah. Kalau you buat 25% more, 75% less, so salah lah. Itu adalah interpretation untuk you punya Q3, you punya third quarter. Okay. So itu adalah untuk the second question. And then the last one, from the above information, sketch the box and whisker plot, okay, of the admission price. Since the data already give you your Q2, Q1, Q3 and then your maximum and minimum, you need to arrange the data, okay, from lowest to highest, and then you boleh dapatlah the minimum and maximum value. Okay, so untuk nak lukis you punya box and whisker plot, you need to have three things. Okay, the first one is the scale. You kena tunjuk dia punya scale, baru you dapat one mark. Okay, and then the second one is your sketch and box, apa, whisker plot ni. Okay, you kena ada tunjuk. Okay, and then the third one is label. So kalau you ada tiga-tiga benda ni, baru you can dapat tiga markah. So make sure you ada scale, you draw and also you label. Okay, so itulah cara macam ni nak dapatkan markah untuk box and whisker plot. Okay, so scale ni follow lah. Okay, kalau you nak apa lebih nampak, jangan rapat-rapat sangat. Sorry, you jangan buat jarak sangat 10, 20. Okay, kalau tu you buat 5 pun dah okay. Bagi you nampak. Okay, nampak dia skew to the left ke, skew to the right. Okay, and then jangan lupa label minimum berapa, Q1 berapa, Q3 berapa, Q3 and also maximum. Okay, and then jangan lupa soalan selalunya dia akan suruh lukis. This is the first question. And then the second one, the question ask you to comment on the shape of distribution. So once you dah lukis ni, you tengoklah dia ke arah mana. So dalam, kalau you tengok kat sini, yang belah kanan ni lebih panjang. So kita kata the shape of distribution is positively skewed or skewed to the right. So you need another one mark. So total is 4 marks. Okay. So this is for question 2. Okay, so you need to know how to construct box and whisker plot, how to get the value for your Q1, Q2 and Q3. So untuk nak dapatkan nilai Q1, Q2 and Q3, so macam saya kata, kalau macam previously dengan apa namanya tu, Puan Balkish, you all dah guna formula. So tak ada masalah lah, you all follow je lah yang formula tu. Tapi kalau dengan saya, okay, kalau dengan saya, saya just apa namanya tu, you just round off je dia punya value. Contohnya, okay, contohnya you kira you dapat you punya value tu kalau untuk apa namanya tu, less than 0.5. Yeah. Kalau you dapat integer tu, okay, kalau you dapat dia halfway between two integers, so nanti you akan pilih yang tengah-tengah. Tapi kalau contohnya macam ni, you dapat 5.25, okay, so you just round off to 5, okay. Kalau contohnya you dapat 10.5, yang ni you dah tahulah kena dapatkan dia punya yang tengah-tengah tu, between 10 dengan 11, okay. So maksudnya 10.5 ni dekat tengah-tengah. So you boleh dapatkan nilai dia. So you just tambah je 10 tambah dengan 11 over dengan 2. So you dapat 3.2. Tapi kalau case untuk 5.25, 5.3 contohnya, okay, 5.4, ataupun you dapat 15.75, okay, ataupun you dapat 15.6. So kalau you dapat point yang macam ni, so macam mana you nak buat? Kalau you dapat less than 0.5, okay, kurang daripada nilai yang ini, you just round down the value. Contohnya kalau 5.3, you just round off kepada 5, position yang kelima. Kalau dia lebih daripada 0.5, contohnya 15.75, so you just apa nama itu, round up je lah. Jadi apa nama itu, 16 macam tu. Okay, and then you terus je lah pilih 44. So this is the value. Okay, tapi kalau you nak guna formula yang tu pun boleh juga, tapi nanti dia jawapan dia beza sikit lah, tapi still acceptable. Okay, kalau you nak guna formula. Apa tak formula tu? yang you ambil dia punya lower value, lepas tu tolak tu ha. Okay, yang tu pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Okay, so itu adalah untuk nak dapatkan nilai you punya Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay, so once you already have all the value and then you just lukis lah. And then untuk nak lukis, you can draw the box and whisker plot whether you want to draw it vertical, okay, ataupun horizontal boleh. Cuma kalau vertical ni, you kena remember dia start bawah ni dengan nilai kosong. Kosong ke atas. Okay, so kalau vertical, you kena tahu pula lah nak tengok dia. Kalau vertical, nak tengok right skew ke left skew ke, kita akan tengok yang belah atas lah, mana lebih panjang. Okay, so itu adalah untuk box and whisker plot. Kalau untuk stem and leaf plot, macam biasa je lah. Okay, you just susun daripada kecil ke besar. And then yang ini mesti ascending order. So ini just tulis je lah nilai dia. So dekat sini nilainya hanya boleh ada satu sahaja. Okay, and then contohnya kalau you have 5.7. So nak lukis dia macam mana? 5, 7. Okay, this is your stem and then this is your leaf plot. Kalau you ada 5.75, macam mana you nak lukis dia, nak tulis dia, since you know that for leaf ni, dia hanya boleh ada satu unit saja, satu nilai saja. So you kena round up dah the value. So dia akan jadi 5.8. Okay, so you kena hanya ada satu saja. Kalau you ada 100.75, so you akan jadikan dia 100.8. So dia akan jadi 108. Okay, so you kena ingat untuk apa nama itu, you punya leaf ni hanya boleh ada satu unit sahaja. Okay, so itu adalah untuk stem and leaf plot. Alright, and then the next question, the last one. So this is the question for confidence interval. Okay, so a researcher selected randomly 70 students from public university and 37 students from private university. Okay, the means and variance on hour per week they spend on assignment for both group are shown as follows. So this is your mean and also your variance. Okay, so ingat the mean and variance is for the sample. Okay, so dalam kes yang ni, construct 99% confidence interval on the difference of mean time spent on assignment for both group. So it, you know that this is the question for two population mean. Okay, so for two population mean, so you tahu untuk two population kita ada case tu sama ada variance or standard deviation for the population is known or unknown. Okay, so dalam case yang ini, since we know that for your variance, okay, the question give you the value for sample variance. So you know that the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown. And then you need to check with the sample size. Okay, sama ada dua-dua tu, okay, dia punya N1 and N2 ni dua-dua more than 30 or salah satu besar, salah satu less than 30 ataupun dua-dua less than 30. Okay, so kalau dua-dua besar, case dia adalah large sample. Tapi kalau salah satu besar, salah satu kecil ataupun dua-dua kecil, case dia adalah small sample. Okay, you kena check lah. So dalam case yang ini, okay, since the case ni kalau you tengok N dia untuk public is 70, yang ni adalah 37. So dua-dua ni more than 30. Okay, more than or equal to 30. So you know that the case is this one. Okay, for variance or standard deviation for the population is unknown untuk large sample. So you kena guna this formula. Okay, nak jawab soalan tu. So you just substitute je the value. Okay, just masukkan dia punya mean and then dia punya alpha ni memang over 2. Okay, ni memang formula dia macam ni. Okay, and then you just substitute je lah nilai dia. Cuma you kena hati-hati since the question already give you the value for variance. Okay, you tak perlu nak square lah the value. Kalau dia bagi standard deviation baru you square the value. Okay, yang tu pun you kena tengok betul-betul. Okay, and then you make sure you show what is the value in the table. Okay, this one you kena show. And then you punya lower and upper limit. Untuk lower, you tolak. Untuk apa you tambah. Okay, so make sure if you want to write the value in bracket, so jangan lupa bracket ni. Okay, kalau you nak buat dalam interval pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Okay. So this is how to answer for question A. Okay, and then for question A2, based on the confidence interval in one, is there is a difference of mean time spent on assignment for both group? So dia tanya based on the confidence interval. The question do not ask you to test. Okay, make sure you can differentiate between confidence interval and also hypothesis testing. So bila dia kata based on confidence interval and then markah dia memang dua sahaja, kita tengok based on nilai zero. Either zero ni ada dalam confidence interval ataupun tak ada dalam confidence interval. Kalau ada, kita kata dia equal. Kalau tak ada, kita kata dia unequal ataupun ada differ. Okay, so dalam kes yang ini, since we know that the value ni, okay, kalau kita tengok 0.3524, so kosong ni ada dalam confidence interval. So kita kata no. Okay, since the question ask you is there is a difference. So kita kata no lah. No, since there is zero in the confidence interval. Okay, so make sure no 1 mark and then reason the 1 mark. Okay, zero is in the confidence interval. So 2 marks lah. Okay, so kita dalam untuk question A. And then kalau soalan tu kata, is there is a difference of mean time spent on assignment for both group? And then dia kata test at alpha 0.05. Contoh. Okay, so bila macam ini, so you kena guna semua steps lah. Dia akan jadi hypothesis testing. Okay, you kena check lah. Okay, public, private. Okay, and then H1, unequal. And then dua kena test. So bila kena test, you kena guna this one lah. Okay, you kena guna yang ini. Okay, so sama je lah dia punya steps dia. Okay, so itu adalah untuk apa nama itu? Untuk A. And then untuk B, so untuk B ni dekat sini dia bagi you a random sample of 9 student. Okay, and it's 9 to test for the effectiveness of a special course designed to improve memory. And then the following table gives a score in the memory test given to these students. Okay, and then the following at 95% confidence interval. So the question asks you on the confidence interval, does the special course design increase the test score? Justify your answer. So since the question asks you on the confidence interval, so you just guna, jadi hanya nak dapatkan lower and upper limit sahaja. So you just guna formula yang ni je lah. Okay, untuk dependent. Okay, yang ini. So you need to find the value for your D bar and also your standard deviation. Okay, you kena cari dua nilai ni dulu. Okay, so make sure untuk value standard deviation, untuk value standard deviation, make sure you hati-hati. Okay, bila you nak tengok apa nama itu, you nak tengok calculator tu, okay, you ambil standard deviation untuk sampel. Okay, you ambil yang nombor 3. So you jangan ambil yang population pula. Nanti salah. Okay, you ambil yang ini. Okay, so ini adalah standard deviation untuk sampel. Okay, so nanti you dah dapatkan nilai dia. So just substitute the value and then make sure you show what is the critical value for T 0.0258. And then you punya lower and upper limit. And then the question asks you whether the special course design increase the test score. So sama, you kena refer to value of zero, whether zero is in the confidence interval or zero is not in the confidence interval. So kalau ada, kita kata dia equal. Kalau tak ada, kita kata unequal, ada increase, ada decrease. So selain daripada equal tu, dia adalah kalau zero tak ada dalam confidence interval. So dekat sini memang kosong tak ada dalam confidence interval. So kita kata yes, since zero is not in the confidence interval. Okay? So ya, ada dua markah lah kat situ. Tapi kalau contohnya soalan tu suruh you test, contohnya dia kata at 5% significant level, at 5% level of significant, does the special course design increase the test score? So kalau dalam kes yang macam ni, so you kena buat step yang ni lah. Okay, mu D is equal to zero. And then untuk nak tentukan sama ada, since the case tu dia bukan tanya difference, contohnya dia tanya efektif ke, dia tanya increase ke, dia tanya reduce ke, maksudnya selain daripada unequal. Hanya difference sahaja yang you akan buat unequal. Kalau dia tanya on apa effectiveness ke, dia tanya on increase ke, reduce ke, you kena refer to you punya D-bar. D-bar you positif ke negatif. Okay, so contohnya dalam kes yang ni, kalau you tengok D-bar you adalah negatif. So So maksudnya dia akan jadi less than 0 lah. Tapi dia membawa maksud increase test score. And then step yang kedua, you punya T calculated guna hypothesis testing. So macam biasa je lah. So make sure you dapat bezakan soalan hypothesis testing and also confidence interval. Kalau dia suruh test at berapa percent level of significance, so you kena buat all the steps. Tapi kalau dia tanya on the confidence interval sahaja, you hanya dapatkan lower end upper limit dia sahaja. Okay, so itu adalah untuk quiz one. Okay, so nanti you check kalau macam you ada nak tanya apa-apa ke, nanti you tanya lepas kelas lah. Right, so untuk the next one is on assignment. Okay, assignment yang hari tu saya bagi. Okay, assignment by group. So untuk assignment, untuk the first question, so kat sini dia dah bagi tahu you punya mu. Okay, so this is the mean for the population, apa yang dia claim. And then you ada a sample of 10. Okay, so this is your n. So this is the value. Okay, ampere per hour. Okay, so you ada 10. And then for A, name the statistical method used in this study, give a reason to support your answer. So statistical method dia adalah one sample t-test. So kalau you tengok dekat SPSS tu memang pun one sample t-test. Okay, since kita nak tengok on one population. Okay, and then kenapa kita guna one sample t-test? Kenapa kita guna t-test? Since kita punya sample tu less than 30. Sebab tu kita guna small sample, kita guna t. Okay, kalau dia more than 30, kita akan guna z-test. Okay, dia bukan t. Okay, so dia punya jawapan dia adalah one sample t-test. And then reason dia kita kata because the size is less than 30 ataupun the sample is less than 30. Okay, so one mark for the statistical method and then reason dia another one mark. And therefore B, at 5% significant level, is there is enough evidence to conclude that the manufacturer claim is true. So apa yang dia claim? Dia claim that the mean capacity for a certain type of battery is 150. So kat sini dia kata dah at 5% significant level. So bila soalan macam tu, you tahulah you kena buat all the steps ni lah. So ini adalah apa yang question ask you. So sama ada dia equal ataupun unequal je lah. Okay, and then you test lah step yang kedua. So for those yang guna SPSS output, so make sure you letak dia punya test value and then you can use the p value. Okay, so mana yang guna manually, you kena show lah macam mana you dapatkan t calculated. Okay, guna formula yang mana, guna formula untuk hypothesis testing. Guna yang inilah. Okay, so you akan guna yang less than 30, so you akan guna yang this one. Okay, so nanti you akan dapat value dia sama. Okay, you akan dapat this one lah. Okay, so since this is the first step, you punya hypothesis, and then the second step is your p-value. Since this is the case for two tail, so p-value is for two tail, so no need to divide by two. Just ambil je value dia. And then your decision rule, and then the decision you compare. So if we say that fail to reject, so question kata the claim is 150, and then bila kita apa nama itu buat decision pun memang kita fail to reject. So kita kata there is enough evidence, okay, to conclude the manufacturer claim that is the true mean capacity is 150. Okay, so this is for the first apa nama itu first question. Okay, so untuk apa nama itu you punya output ni I bagi 2 marks lah. So mana yang tak buat output, saya bagi dekat you punya calculation untuk kira T tu lah. Okay, so itu adalah and then apa nama itu yang you kira mean dengan standard deviation. Okay, mana yang tak guna output. Alright, so itu adalah untuk first question. And then the second question, so dekat sini adalah comparison of the effectiveness of distance learning using traditional classroom, 12 student to a business administration course online, and then 14 dia ambil dekat dalam classroom. So do the data provide sufficient evidence to conclude that there is a significant difference in the final score between two learning method? So dalam case yang ni, nak tak nak memang you kena guna SPSS output. Sebab you kena test dulu guna living test whether the case is equal or unequal. Okay, you kena test dulu guna living test. So you kena ada nilai p-value untuk living test tu. So you kena apa nama itu masukkan data tu dalam SPSS lah. So this is the value. Okay, so untuk apa nama itu living test ni, so make sure you buat simbol dia ni betul-betul tau. Okay, mostly yang saya jumpa kalau tengok you all just buat macam ni je. dia tertinggal lah dia punya satu dengan dia punya dua tu. Ha. So jadi salah lah. Okay. Tak betul lah you punya ni. So kalau macam you rasa simbol tu you tak pasti, so you tak perlu buat simbol. You just buat dalam sentence saja. Kita kata assume equal variance, assume unequal variance. Okay boleh. Yeah, so kalau you tak confident dengan dia punya apa nama itu, simbol, you just buat dalam bentuk ayat saja. Asalkan h null you equal h1 you unequal. Jangan terbalik pula. Okay. And then p-value you refer to living task. P-value for the living task. And then you just compare and then you dapat fail to reject. So kita kata equal. Okay. So itu adalah untuk living task. So once kita tahu dia adalah equal, so untuk next question, okay, do the data provide sufficient evidence to conclude that there is a significant difference? So untuk second questions tu, you akan ambil p-value untuk yang equal lah. Okay, equal variance. So yang bawah ni, you tak tengok lah. Okay. So, untuk nilai yang ini, you kena hati-hati. Since the case is two-tail, p-value is also for two-tail. So you just ambil sahaja nilai dia. Okay, and then you compare, you dapat fail to reject. So maksud kita kata sama sahaja. Okay, dia punya apa nama itu? Dia punya final score tu, so kita kata insufficient evidence untuk mengatakan ada difference. Okay. So itu adalah untuk second question. And then the third question. So dekat sini dia kata score task after the workshop. So you ada students yang sama. 2, 4, 6, 8. You ada 8 students. So n is equal to 8. So you ada pre-test and post-test. Kita nak tengok ada beza tak dia punya score tu. So you know that this is the question for dependent. Okay. So dependent since dia kata there is an improvement. So macam saya kata, selain dia daripada perkataan difference, so maksudnya untuk you punya H1 tu you kena tengok sama ada less than or more than. Kalau kat sini dia kata there is a difference, ini memang automatically you know that your H1 is unequal. Okay, kalau selain daripada perkataan difference, dia kata effectiveness ke, reduce ke, improve ke, apa-apa tu, so you kena refer to your D-bar. Sama ada nilai D-bar itu negatif ke positif. Kalau negatif dia less than, kalau positif dia more than. Okay. So dalam case yang ini, since you know that this is the case for dependent, so you can dapatkan output yang ni lah. Okay, and then kita since dekat sini I let pre-test minus post-test. Okay, so you punya D-bar ni dia akan jadi less than zero lah. Since you punya D-bar ni negatif. Okay, kalau you mana yang buat post tolak dengan pre, so you punya H1 dia akan jadi more than zero. Since nanti mini you akan dapat positif. And then for p-value, since the case is one tail, so you kena bahagi dengan dua lah. Since p-value ni dibagi untuk two tail. So walaupun nilai dia adalah 0.000, make sure you show you divide by two. Maksudnya you fahamlah konsep dia. Okay? So make sure you show apa nama itu, walaupun nilai dia akan dapat sama saja, tapi saya nak awak tunjuk. Okay? And then buat macam biasa, so nanti you dapat reject. So bila reject, kita kata enough evidence to conclude that there is an improvement. Okay, so itu adalah untuk question 3. And then for question 4, so this is the question for ANOVA. Okay, so you just masukkan je data tiga-tiga ni and then you pilih compare one way ANOVA. So nanti you akan dapat output yang macam ni lah. Okay, so this is the output. And then dekat sini question ask you at 2.5% significant level, can you conclude that the mean time taken to provide relief from gastric pain is the same for all three brands? Okay, so this is the question. Dia tanya sama tak? Okay, and then untuk H1, so hari tu saya dah mention, nak selamat, you buat je at least one pair of treatment means. Okay, tapi yang mana yang masih buat two treatment means ataupun one treatment mean tu, saya masih terima lah. Okay, sebab macam saya kata, kalau guna one ataupun two, dia macam ada isu. Sebab ada yang kata one, ada yang kata two treatment yang differ. So nak selamat, you guna je one pair. One pair of treatment means are differ. Okay, so soalan tanya sama ada semua sama. So yang ni you kena hati-hati. Kalau you ada tiga, so make sure you tulis tiga. Okay, saya tengok yang hari apa, project hari tu pun ada yang careless. You ada empat, you dah list dah empat. Tiba-tiba bila you write you punya rational, you buat tiga je. Ha, so dah silap lah kat situ. Okay, sayang. So itu adalah untuk you punya hypothesis. And then for p-value, you just ambil je value dia. Tak perlu nak dibahagi ke darab dua. And then just compare, so you fail to reject. So memang kita mengatakan dia sama. So there is enough evidence untuk mengatakan dia sama. Yeah, so that is for question 4. And then the last one for question 5. So this is the question for cross tabulation. Since you have two variable, okay, two categorical variable. Okay, So mana yang guna SPSS output, so you akan dapat this output lah. Okay, you ada cross tabulation and also chi-square test. Yes, so untuk you punya, kat sini question ask you whether failure is independent of the mounting position. So macam saya kata follow dia punya soalan. Kalau soalan tu kata independent, guna independent. Kalau soalan tu kata association, follow association. And then make sure jangan terbalik. Yang untuk H0, apa-apa yang tak ada kaitan. Untuk H1, apa-apa yang ada kaitan. Okay, so make sure jangan terbalik. And then p-value just ambil saja. This is the p-value. And then buat macam biasa. So untuk conclusion, you ada pilihan. Sama ada kalau reject, you terus tulis the type of failure is dependent. Ataupun you cakap there is not enough evidence to conclude that the type of failure is independent. Okay, so this is for apa namanya tu question, last question. Okay, and then the next one kita nak tengok on test. Okay, test hari tu. Okay, so for test. Okay, you ada berapa? 5 questions. Okay, so untuk first question. So this is the question for dependent. Since kat sini memang paired sample test. So kat sini dia kata result in weight loss. And then test at 5% significant level whether the product is effective in promoting weight loss. So macam saya kata bila dia selain daripada difference. So you punya apa nama itu? You punya H1 ni, you akan refer kepada you punya D-bar lah. Okay, kalau D-bar dia less apa negatif, so less than 0. Okay, kalau kat sini difference saja baru you buat unequal. Okay, and then since the questions ni already give you the value 40 calculated, so no need to show. Okay, how you get the value. Okay, just ambil saja daripada output. Okay. So you just ambil saja. So you just show the value. Okay, mu d is equal to 0 and then mu d is less than 0. Okay, so this is the questions. And then tikal, tak perlu nak show, just ambil daripada output. And then the second, the next step is your critical value. Since the case is one tail, left tail, so you punya critical value mesti negatif. Okay, mesti ada negative value. And then kita punya decision rule, rejection if tikal is less than negative t critical value. So you compare these two value. Since the value is less than, so you reject your H0. So kita mengatakan memang apa nama itu the product is effective. So kita kata there is enough evidence to conclude that the product is effective in promoting the weight loss. So itulah untuk the first question. And then the second question state the type 1 and type 2 error in the context of the test. So dalam kes yang ni dia bukan nak tanya definition type 1 error tu apa, type 2 error tu apa. Dia nak you kaitkan type 1 and type 2 error tu dekat dalam question yang ni. Okay, so macam mana nak buat dia? Since you know that your H0 ni, your H0 ni kita kata not effective. Untuk H1 ni kita kata dia effective. Okay, so kalau you refer balik kepada you punya table untuk apa nama itu type 1 and type 2 error. Lalu you tengok. Type 1 and type 2 error. So untuk type 1 error tu you tahu. Okay, dia punya konsep dia adalah you akan reject you punya H0 walaupun H0 tu true. You reject dia. So jadi false positive. And then untuk type 2 error tu you akan fail to reject you punya H0 walaupun you tahu H0 tu adalah salah. So macam mana nak kaitkan apa nama itu, nak kaitkan dia. So dekat sini untuk type 1 error ni kita tahu kita akan reject H0 bila H0 tu true. So maksudnya kita conclude the product is effective. Okay, kita conclude the product is effective while it is not effective. So mana yang buat sampai the product is effective saja saya bagi half marks je lah. Okay, so you kena bagi tahu sebenarnya product tu apa, you conclude product tu effective tapi sebenarnya dia tak effective. Sebab tu terjadinya type 1 error. Kita reject H0 when H0 is true. Okay. So itulah untuk type 1 error. And then for type 2 error, kita fail to reject H0 when H0 is false. So maksudnya kita kata product tu not effective. Okay, kita kata product tu not effective padahal dia effective. Sebab apa kita kata dia not effective? Sebab berlakunya type 2 error, kita fail to reject our H0. Padahal H0 ni false. Patutnya kita kata dia effective tapi kita kata dia not effective. Okay, kalau type 1 error ni, sepatutnya dia tak efektif. Ini true. Tapi kita reject dia. Kita kata dia efektif. Okay. So ini adalah macam mana you nak kaitkan type 1 and type 2 error dengan dia punya soalan. So kalau untuk type 1 error ni kita conclude dia efektif. Padahal dia tak efektif pun. Kalau berlaku type 2 error kita kata dia not efektif. Padahal dia efektif. Okay. So itulah untuk the first question. And then the second question. This is the question for ANOVA. Okay, so dia dah bagi dekat you ANOVA table, so tak ada masalah. Okay, and then identify the factor and response variable for the above experiment. So untuk dia punya factor, so factor dia adalah detergent ni. So this is your factor. And then your response is the whiteness reading of the white cotton cloth. Okay, so this is your factor ataupun independent variable you. So this is the response or dependent variable you. Okay, and then the second question, do the data provide sufficient evidence to indicate that the average reading of white cotton cloth among the type of detergent is the same? Okay, since you have four detergent, so bila you buat you punya hypothesis tu, okay, you akan buat this one lah ada empat. And then at least one pair of treatment means are differ. And then untuk p-value, you just refer saja. This is your p-value. Okay, so buat macam biasa. So make sure you listkan you punya p-value, decision rule, decision and then conclusion. Insufficient untuk mengatakan dia sama. Okay, since the question ask you whether the ni is equal tapi you reject, you kata dia differ. So kita kata insufficient evidence lah untuk mengatakan dia sama. Okay, so that is for question 2. And then for question 3, okay, so this is the question for two population mean. You have brand A and also brand B. And then for the first question, based on the p-value in the living test, okay, this one, what is the assumption for equality of variances? Okay, so macam biasa, you just buat je. So kalau you nak refer kepada question, so you just guna A dengan B je lah. So this is your hypothesis, this is your p-value. So you compare fail to reject, so you say that equal variance. So bila dah tahu equal variance, so you just baca untuk equal variance saja. So yang ni you tak tengok lah. Okay, so untuk independent sample test, dia punya output tu boleh jadi macam ni dalam bentuk vertikal ataupun dalam bentuk horizontal. So make sure you boleh bacalah dua-dua. Okay, you tahu macam nak baca untuk dua-dua. So untuk yang ini dah question memang suruh you guna p-value. So you kena guna p-value lah. So p-value dia adalah this one. Cuma dia kata sama ada brand A is more than brand B. Jadi you kena hati-hati since p-value is for two tail. You punya case is one tail. So you punya p-value you need to divide by two. Okay. And then buat macam biasa. So you kata fail. So you kata dia sama je. So kita kata insufficient evidence untuk mengatakan brand A is more than brand B. Okay. And then untuk the next question. Okay. So this is the question for one population mean. So macam biasa kalau keluar soalan macam ni, make sure you list out all the symbol. Okay. Macam ni dia kata found that the mean service time for a car is 15.4. Okay, so sebelum tu memang tak ada sample size. So you know that this is the mean or the average for the population. So this is your mu. Mu is this one. And then standard deviation. So this is the standard deviation for population, sigma. Okay, and then barulah a random sample of 27 car, mean service is this one. And then at 2.5% significant level, do the data contradict with the owner of the car wash claim? Apa yang dia claim? Dia kata less than. They claim less than 15.4. So the question ask you whether the data contradict. So inilah question dia. Okay, maksudnya nak kata dia equal to 15.4. Okay. So nanti bila you test, since you know that the case is variance or standard deviation for the population is known. So bila known, nak tak nak you kena guna this one, Z. Z calculated. Okay, sebab case dia adalah variance or standard deviation for the population is known. Okay, so you guna this one. Okay, nanti you akan dapat this is the value. And then for critical value, since the case is one tail, so no need to divide by two. The alpha ni tak perlu bahagi dua pun. Okay, kita guna negative Z alpha, then you dapat negative 1.96. And then you just compare, you reject. So bila you reject, maksudnya dia tak contradict lah dengan soalan. So kita kata the data do not contradict with the owner of the car wash claim. Okay, so macam tu je lah untuk question 3. Okay. And then untuk the next one, untuk question 4. So this is the question for independent sample, test of independence. So find the value of D and E. So D ni you kena guna formula. Okay, and then make sure jawapan tu dalam satu decimal place. And then E ni you just tolak sahaja. You tak boleh guna formula. Since ini adalah untuk observe ataupun untuk count value. Okay, so just tolak 140, tolak 39, tolak 65 ataupun 54, tolak 18. So ambil nilai yang atas ni lah. Okay, jangan you ambil nilai bawah. Salah lah. Okay. So itu adalah untuk D and E. And then for B, at 1% significant level, if there is enough evidence to indicate that the type of survey has an association with tourist opinion. So dalam kes yang ni, nak tak nak, you kena guna chi-square calculated. Since dekat sini, p-value tak diberi. Okay, you tak boleh guna p-value. So you kena hati-hati. So mana yang guna p-value tu memang salah lah. Since you tak boleh guna p-value. Okay, so dalam kes yang itu, you kena guna. So this is untuk D, you kena show. And then untuk E, you just tolak sahaja. And then untuk B, so make sure you guna perkataan no association and an association. Mana yang buat independent dengan dependent tu, saya just bagi satu markah saja. Okay. And then you punya chi-square calculated. Macam saya kata, you hanya boleh guna chi-square calculated, tak boleh guna p-value. Since there is no value for p-value. Okay, and then you punya critical value, decision rule, then you compare these two values, so you reject. You just kata, the type of survey has an association. Okay, ataupun kalau you nak tengok in, apa nama tu, based on the question, so kita kata enough evidence untuk mengatakan ada association. Okay. So, and the last one untuk question 5. Okay, so you dah ada model summary and also the coefficient. So this is your R square. Then this is your A, this is your B. So untuk you punya coefficient, apa nama itu? Correlation coefficient dia tak ada kat situ. So you kena kira lah. So untuk yang A, state the independent and response of the variable. So you tahulah this is your X. Your X is distance. And then your Y is the, apa nama itu? Cost of the fire damage. So this is your independent variable and also your punya dependent variable. So nak selamat, you just letak siap-siap dia punya unit dia. And then for B, since dalam case yang ini, you do not have any data. Okay, so bila you tak ada data, so nak kira you punya correlation coefficient, you punya R kecil ni, you kena tengok based on you punya R square. So untuk yang R square ni, you kena tahu nilai dia adalah plus minus. Okay. So untuk nak tentukan sama ada dia plus ataupun minus, you need to refer to the slope. Make sure you mention. Since the value of slope is positive, baru you punya R tu positive. Okay, you tak boleh simply kata positive. Okay, you tak boleh terus buat kata dia positive. So apa you punya, apa nama itu, mengatakan reason yang mengatakan dia positive. So you kena mention, kaitkan dengan value of slope. Okay, so mana yang just buat positif saja, saya bagi satu markah saja. Okay, mana yang bagi reason, since the value of slope is positive, R is positive, yang tu saya bagi dua markah. Okay, so this one satu markah, this one satu markah. Okay, so itu adalah untuk dia punya value of R, and then the question ask you to interpret. Okay, so kat sini tiga markah. So bila interpret, so kita kata there is a strong positive linear relationship. Mana yang tertinggal positif, sorry, mana yang tertinggal strong ataupun mana yang tertinggal positif. Yang tu tak dapat full marks lah. Okay. So make sure ada empat-empat ni lah. Strong, positive, linear relationship. Barulah betul. Okay, dia punya jawapan. Okay. So itu adalah untuk dia punya soalan B. And then the next one, comment on what would happen if the distance between burning house and the nearest fire station is too far. Okay, so yang ni kita just cakap, apa nama itu, the further the distance, the higher the cost. So siapa-siapa yang mention higher the cost dapat one marks. And then jangan lupa dia punya reason dia kenapa, since the slope is positive. Ataupun since you kata there is a strong positive linear relationship between X and Y, bolehlah. Okay, any relevant answers saya terima. Okay, so that is for C. And then for D, okay, state the value of the coefficient of determination, interpret the value. So this is the value. So bila soalan kata state, make sure you take the value from the output. Okay, ambil nilai yang ini. Kalau you buat 4.0, so salah lah, you tak state. And then you kena hati-hati. Mana yang kira yang ini, you squarekan value dia and then you buat 4 decimal places. So saya tak bagi markah lah kat sini, kat situ eh. Saya hanya bagi markah untuk apa, interpretation saja. Since nilai tu you tak state. Okay, kalau dia kata state, ambil daripada output. So buat je macam biasa, the total variation of your Y is explained by the variation of your X, and then balance it explained by the variable. And then for the last one, The question asks you what is the cost if the distance is 5,700 meter. So ini kena hati-hati since the unit is in kilometer. Okay, and then dia punya data kat situ adalah dalam meter. So you kena tukar dulu. Okay, kepada kilometer. Barulah you substitute. Okay, and then jawapan jangan lupa dia punya unit dia 1,000. Okay, so kalau you tertinggal memang memang salah. Okay, so itu adalah untuk test. Okay, so ada any questions tak untuk assessment? Okay, so nanti mana yang nak tanya untuk jawapan you nanti you boleh tanya after class lah. Okay, so kalau tak ada any questions, kita tengok on past questions. Okay, untuk February 2021. So this is the previous one. Okay, untuk last semester punya. Okay, so kalau you tengok, kita memang hanya ada masa 2 sahaja. Okay, 2 sahaja. Sorry, 2 jam sahaja. Okay, and then you ada 7 questions. Okay, so untuk the first question. Okay, so ini adalah question untuk topic 1. Okay, so dekat dalam case ni, state the population and sample for the above study. So kat sini you ada research team from KQ University. There ada 5 faculty. And then there are 1,500 undergraduate students registered in the current semester. So this is your population. So the list of all students name arranged alphabetically by faculty was obtained. So a random sample of 150 students was selected randomly from each faculty. And information on gender, age, monthly expenditure on food and type of food purchase were collected. So for A, state the population and sample for the above study. So ini adalah apa nama itu example. Nanti saya akan bagi untuk apa nama itu borang saya makan skrip ni. Nanti saya akan bagi dekat you. So nanti untuk hari Jumaat ni, so make sure you compile sekali dengan you punya jawapan tu dengan borang saya makan skrip ni. So yang ni dia letak dekat front page lah. Dia nanti senang saya nak kira markah you. So nanti you just tulis you punya student ID and then nama you. Senang saya nak key in markah nanti and then you punya faculty, program code and then nama saya. And then untuk first and second seminar ni you buat siap-siap 7 question. Okay, and then yang bawah ni you just biar sahaja. And then baru you buat jawapan you. Okay, so untuk question 1, so untuk population, so macam saya kata make sure you ada perkataan all. Okay, all, and then since dekat dalam questions ni dah bagi dekat you figure. Dah bagi dekat you figure untuk semua students dekat dalam current semester tu 1,500. So you can write the figure all 1,500 undergraduate students in QQ University. So make sure you mention undergraduate students. Kalau you just buat all 1,500 saja titik, so you punya jawapan salah. So make sure you mention siapa undergraduate students dekat mana QQ University. Baru you dapat 1 marks. So make sure you ada all undergraduate students QQ University. Baru you dapat 1 mark. Kalau you tertinggal tak ada QQ University, you tak dapat. Okay, so untuk permarkahan untuk final usually dia akan 1 atau 0. Dia tak ada half-half. Okay, so untuk yang assessment je saya bagi half. Tapi kalau untuk final, since dia adalah common marking, so usually dia memang 1 atau salah. Okay, so kalau you tak ada QQ University tu kira salah lah walaupun you ada all. Okay, so make sure ayat tu lengkap lah sampai you tak boleh nak tanya undergraduate student daripada mana. So make sure you buat ayat tu lengkap. Okay, and then untuk sample, so untuk sample ni you kena hati-hati. Okay, since soalan ni pun sama, dia adalah soalan stratified. So kalau you nak mention 150 orang student sahaja, so you punya jawapan adalah salah. Okay, so kalau you nak kata 150, mesti you cakap from each faculty. Okay, kalau you kata 150 student saja, undergraduate student saja, your answer will be wrong. So you kena mention 150 students selected from each faculty, baru jawapan you betul. Ataupun you cakap 750 undergraduate from 5 faculty. Boleh. Okay. So itu adalah untuk apa nama itu? Untuk you punya jawapan ni. Ataupun you nak kata 750 selected from 5 faculty. Boleh juga. Okay. So yang ini kalau you nak mention all 1,500 undergraduate students from 5 faculty in QQ University pun boleh. Tak ada masalah. Okay, so inilah untuk the first question. And then for the second question, take the sampling frame for the above study. So ingat, untuk sampling frame, okay, dia punya keyword adalah a list, ni tak kisah you nak guna name ke for number ke, a list name of, and then you punya population. So kena ada all, kena ada all. Okay, so a list name of all, so you salin balik je lah you punya population. So a list name, so ni boleh anything. Tapi dekat dalam kalau you tengok on the context of the questions, dia kata the list of all students name arranged alphabetically by faculty was obtained. Okay, so yang ni pun betul juga. You boleh buat sama ada you nak tulis this one ataupun you kata a list name of all 1,500 undergraduate students in QQ University. So this is your population. So keyword all ni kena ada. You kena ada nama semua you punya population. It's senarai nama. So a list name of all 1,500 undergraduate students in QQ. Kalau you buat a list name of 750 selected undergraduate students, your answer is wrong. Untuk sampling frame, kita kena ada list untuk semua population. Bukan list untuk sampel sahaja. You kena ada list untuk all the population. Sebab tu kat sini a list name of all 1,500 undergraduate students. Okay. And then untuk the last one, name any two variable from the above study. From each variable chosen, state its type and the scale of the measurement. Since kat sini you have a few variable, okay, you can choose either one lah, either two. Okay, kena pilih dua lah daripada tiga. Okay, daripada tiga. So, apa nama tu nak mudah, you just buat dalam table macam ni. Variable, type of variable and then scale of measurement dia apa. Okay, kalau age, dia punya type of variable dia adalah quantitative discrete and then scale dia adalah ratio. Kalau monthly expenditure, quantitative continuous, ratio. Kalau type of food, qualitative nominal. Okay, so you just pilih dua je lah daripada tiga. Okay, so itulah untuk the first question. And then untuk the second question, so ini adalah soalan descriptive. So dia bagi dekat you ada dua group. Okay, so the first group adalah student number 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. So this is for group A. Okay, and then yang the balance tu untuk group B lah. So untuk A, calculate the sample GPA mean and standard deviation for group A. So you just ambil nilai yang ini sajalah. You just ambil nilai yang untuk group A saja. So bila dia suruh cari the sample mean and also the standard deviation, so you need to show how you get the value. Okay. So make sure walaupun question 1 ni hanya you perlukan 10 baris sahaja, make sure the next question you start with a new page. Okay, supaya senang je saya nak marking. Okay, so walaupun ada balance, walaupun you hanya guna 2 baris saja, make sure untuk next question you start dengan page baru. Okay, so ini adalah untuk you punya mean and standard deviation for group A. So just show je what is the value, nanti you akan dapat this one. Dan untuk standard deviation you akan dapat nilai this one lah. So make sure macam saya kata, nak dapatkan nilai yang ini dengan yang ini, you can get from calculator. Tapi untuk standard deviation ni, make sure you hati-hati ambil nilai yang ketiga, yang ini. Jangan ambil nilai yang kedua. Ha, yang ni salah. Okay, ambil yang ketiga. Baru you dapat nilai standard deviation dia. Okay, and then untuk yang B, what is the mean and standard deviation for those who not selected? So, mana yang tak selected tu, so you just total up saja value dia. So, nanti akan dapat mean and standard deviation nilai yang ni lah. 3.22 dengan 0.5218. Okay, so make sure you show the value. And then the last one, using appropriate measurement, determine which of the group is less dispersed. Okay, so you tahu this is the coefficient of variation, CV. Dia punya formula dia adalah standard deviation over your mean, sample mean darat dengan 100%. So since nilai ni ada dapat, so just substitute je lah. So make sure nilai yang ni dia dapat betul. Kalau dia dah salah kat sini, so bawah ni pun salah nanti. Okay, so make sure you kira betul-betul nilai tu. So you compare. So since the question asks you which one is less dispersed, so you kena refer baliklah dekat coefficient of variation table dia tu, ha. Nak tentukan nilai dia yang mana satu. Kalau dia kata more dispersed macam mana? Kalau dia kata less dispersed macam mana? Ha, this one. Okay, kalau more dispersed, you ambil yang largest. Kalau less dispersed, you ambil yang smallest. Okay, kalau less consistent, you ambil yang largest. So make sure you tengok soalan tu minta yang mana satu. Okay. So itu adalah untuk ni. So kita kata group A is less dispersed. Okay, since it has the smallest percentage of coefficient of variation. Okay. So this is the second question. And then the next one, so start with a new page. So ini adalah soalan stem and leaf plot. So obtain the first, second and third quarter for the above data. So nak kira Q1, Q2, Q3, guna this formula lah. Q1, 1 over 4, Q2, 1 over 2, Q3, 3 over 4. And then macam yang saya mention tadi, kalau nilai dia adalah 0.5, so you just tambahkan dua nilai tu over 2. Okay, maksudnya you tambah 7 and 8 position. Okay, yang ni tambah 22 and 23. Tapi kalau you dapat contohnya 7.25, so you just pilih position yang ketujuh saja. So maksudnya you just ambil nilai Q1 dia adalah 50 macam tu. Okay, so this is the value for Q1, Q2 and Q3. And then once you already get the value, the next question asks you to sketch the box and whisker plot for the above data, hence comment on the marks distribution. So macam saya kata, make sure you have all the three things, scale, you punya box and whisker plot and also label. Okay, so untuk yang ni, make sure you ambil betul-betul lah dia punya scale tu. Okay, janganlah dia punya scale tu kejap ni, kejap besar. Nanti bila you lukis tu, you tak nampak dia punya skewness tu arah ke mana. So make sure dia sama je. Okay. So kalau ni, you guna je pembaris ambil dia punya scale tu. Okay, so this is the value. Okay, and then dia suruh comment on the, apa nama tu, shape of distribution. Since kalau you tengok, dia panjang belah kanan. So kita kata positively skew ataupun skew to the right. And then the last one, suggest an appropriate measurement to determine the marks distribution. Okay, so kita boleh guna Pearson coefficient of skewness. Okay, ni adalah measurement untuk kira skewness. Okay, so itu adalah untuk question 3. The next one for question 4. Okay, so this is the question for 2 population mean. And then the first question asks you, what is the variable in this study? So untuk variable, you kena tahu, this is your variable, leader performance. Okay, male and female ni adalah you punya apa nama itu, you punya ni je, apa nama itu, dia punya independent variable je. Apa yang kita nak test, kita nak test on the leader performance. So dekat sini, what is the variable in this study? Kita nak tengok adalah kita nak tengok leader performance. Okay, so ini adalah jawapan dia, leader performance. And then state the null and alternative hypothesis for the above the above test. So untuk B ni actually you need to refer with the question D. Okay, yang dia nak tahu pasal gender differences. Okay, between male and female. So next question start with a new page. So you let one as male, second as female. So the question only ask you on the hypothesis testing. Okay, your null and alternative hypothesis. So just tulis ini sahaja. Okay, and then the next question ask you on the assumption of the variances. So you kena tengok on the test of equality, this one. So equal or unequal, p-value, you test, you dapat conclusion dia adalah unequal. So bila unequal, maksudnya you akan tengok based on this one sahaja. Okay, equal variances not assumed. So untuk D, so since you already write your hypothesis on B, so for D you tak perlu tulis hypothesis lah, start with the p-value. Ataupun you nak guna p-calculated boleh, tak ada masalah. So p-value, you akan baca p-value yang not assume. Okay, equal variance not assume this one. Since the case is two-tailed, so tak ada masalah lah. You just ambil the value. Tak perlu nak bahagi dua ataupun darab dua. Okay, and then you kata fail to reject. So question tanya tadi sama ada ada difference. Tapi kita fail to reject. So kita kata not enough evidence to conclude that there is a gender differences in leader performance score of employees on task skill in the QQ University. So that is for question D. And then the last one, state. Bila soalan kata state, maksudnya just ambil nilai tu daripada output. State the 95% confidence interval of the mean gender differences in leader performance score of employing on task skill in the QQ University. So since tadi kita memang dah kata unequal, kita dah test dapat yang ini. So bila ditulis, ditulis yang ni lah, lower and upper limit. So Kalau dekat output tu ada 7 decimal places, you kena tulis 7 decimal places. Tak boleh you nak genapkan jadi 4 saja. Since the question ask you to state. So apa decimal places yang ada dekat output tu, you kena tulislah. Okay, and then make sure don't forget the bracket. Okay, so you kena ada semua ni. And then the question ask you whether interval further prove the conclusion in D. Yang mana kita kata based on D ni, kita kata kita dapat equal. So macam mana nak tahu betul ke equal? Kita kena tengok zero tu ada ke tak ada dalam confidence interval. Kalau ada, kita kata equal. Kalau tak ada, kita kata unequal. Since kalau you tengok kat sini kosong memang ada, so memang kita kata dia equal. Maksudnya dia betul lah. Sama lah dengan conclusion dekat D. Kita kata equal. So kita kata yes, since zero is in the confidence interval. Okay. So itu adalah untuk E. Okay. Ataupun you cakap yes, there is no significant difference since zero is in the confidence interval. Boleh. Okay. So itu adalah untuk E. And then the next question, question 5. So this is the ANOVA table. Okay. So kalau you perasan, kalau ada, apa nama itu? Kalau ada ANOVA. Okay. Kalau ada ANOVA, you tengok tak ada soalan dependent. Kalau ada soalan dependent, dia tak ada ANOVA. Macam saya katalah, dia selalu salah satu je. Okay, kalau you tengok on July 2020, dia ada dependent tapi tak ada ANOVA. Okay, so dia akan masuk salah satu je lah. Since dekat sini dia masuk ke ANOVA, so dependent questions tak ada. Okay. So, tapi tak tahulah untuk hari Jumaat ni. Sebab saya pun macam saya kata, saya tak tahu soalan. So, saya pun tak pasti macam mana. Okay. So, untuk ANOVA, state the null and alternative hypothesis. Since dekat sini dia kata, you ada 4 brand of medicine. So maksudnya untuk hash null you kena ada 4 lah. So start with ni new page. So sini make sure ada 4. Kalau tak ada 4, salah lah you punya hash null. And then hash 1 you at least one pair of treatment means are differ. And then since the next question is there is sufficient evidence to indicate that there is a difference in time taken. So kat sini dia kata difference. So untuk B, since dekat A you already write the hypothesis. So untuk B tak perlu pun. Okay, and then kalau you tengok output ni, dia hanya memang ada F calculated saja, tak ada P value. So nak tak nak memang you kena guna F calculated. Okay, and then untuk you punya V1 and V2, okay, so this is the value 3 and 21. And then kalau you tengok, value ni juga tak ada dalam table. So apa yang you perlu buat, you kena round down the value. Kena tengok dia punya yang ke bawah lah, bukan tengok ke atas. Okay, so untuk statistical table, you hanya refer kepada statistical ke table yang ini sahaja. Kalau nilai tu tak ada dekat dalam table yang ini, maksudnya you round down the value. Okay, you jangan pergi Google pula cari nilai berapa, apa nama itu? F yang ni lah. Okay, you jangan Google pula cari nilai yang ini berapa. Okay, you just round down value dia kepada 20. Maksudnya you just refer untuk statistical table yang ini sahaja. Okay, sebab statistical table ni ada banyak. Tapi untuk kita punya syllabus, kita refer to this one. Okay, jangan Google pula tak jumpa dia punya apa nilai tu. Okay, you just guna table yang dah ada je. So compare, you dapat reject. So bila reject, since the question ask you whether there is a difference and then you memang reject. So memang kita kata sufficient evidence untuk mengatakan ada difference. Okay. And then the next question is on test of independence. Okay, question 6. So dalam kes yang ini, compute A and B using the correct formula. So for A, it is the expected count. So guna total row kali total column bahagi dengan you punya sample size. Total sample size. So for A and B, both use the same formula. So since the case is one decimal place, so kat sini pun samalah, you follow satu decimal saja. Okay. And then untuk B at 0.05 level of significance, there is evidence of a significant association between committing time and stress. So walaupun dia tanya association, tapi you punya hash null tetap no association. So jangan buat independent, dependent ataupun no relationship, has relationship. Follow soalan. Kalau dia guna association, follow association. Tapi make sure ini no, yang ini and. Jangan terbalik. Okay. And then untuk the second step, since there is no SPSS output, okay, untuk dia punya value, P value ataupun chi-square calculated, nak tak nak you need to calculate manually. Okay, you kena kira manually all the value. So nanti you akan dapat this is the value and then for critical value you akan dapat 0.05 and then you punya degree of freedom. Since you have 3 row, So 3 minus 1 times with 3 minus 1. So you dapat 4 lah, you punya degree of freedom. Okay. So nanti you just compare. So since the value is less than, so you fail to reject your H-null. So we say that there is no association between committing time and stress. Ataupun you cakap there is enough, ataupun you cakap, oh, there is not enough evidence. There is not enough evidence to conclude that there is an association. Okay. So kalau nak guna enough, not enough, you boleh refer lah soalan tu. Okay. And the last one, the question for bivariate analysis. Okay, so start with a new page. Okay, so untuk bivariate analysis, okay, you dia dapat dekat sini you punya data X and Y. Okay, compute the coefficient of correlation and interpret the coefficient. Nak tak nak, you kena kira. Okay, so make sure nak dapatkan nilai summation of X, summation of Y ni, you gunakan apa nama itu? Calculator. Ambil yang masukkan X and Y, ada dua nilai ni. Okay, and then jangan masukkan nilai yang terbalik. Masukkan X dulu baru nilai Y. Okay, guna calculator. And then apa nama itu, just substitute. So kalau you nak kira satu-satu pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Ataupun you terus just substitute dalam formula. Okay, maksudnya nilai yang ini, you buat R is equal to this one over square root of this one is equal to X77. Boleh juga. Okay, mana-mana asalkan you show what is the value for SSXY, SSXX and also SSYY. Okay, and then baru you tunjuk nilai R. So nilai R ni you boleh calculate manually ataupun you nak guna calculator boleh. Tak ada masalah. Okay. So make sure this one ada square root. Okay. Jangan you tertinggal square root. Nanti jawapannya salah lah. Okay. And then jangan lupa untuk interpret. Since the question ask you to interpret. So there is a strong positive linear relationship between MAT attitude score and performance of all executives. Okay. And then the second question, obtain the linear regression equation model and interpret the slope. Okay, so you kena cari nilai you punya slope and also intercept. So you just use the formula ataupun you can check the answer with the calculator. Since you dah ada value tu, you masukkan dalam apa nama itu equation. And then don't forget to let your X and also your Y head. Okay, kalau you tak nak buat macam ni, you just boleh tulis je. Performance is equal to plus ni and then MAT attitude score boleh. Okay, mana-mana yang mudah. Okay, so itulah untuk you punya equation. And then the next question ask you to apa, interpret the slope. So ada dua, satu you tulis regression equation model and then the second one is interpret the slope. So kita kata since this is your slope, so every one point, so jangan lupa unit dia, this one is always increase in your X. So your Y will increase. Why increase? Since there is a positive value of slope by and then dia punya unit dia. Okay. So that is for B and then for C, calculate the coefficient of determination and interpret the value obtained. So dia sudah calculate. So you just squarekan the value and then interpret macam biasa. This is your Y, this is your X. Okay. And then the last one, dia suruh kira what is the, predict the performance of employee kalau dia punya MAT attitude dia adalah 75 point. Since unit dia sama, tak ada masalah, dia substitute saja. So unit dia jangan lupa. Okay. So this is the question for last semester punya. So make sure nanti bila you submit your answer for apa nama itu, your answer script, make sure you ada this one, front cover. Nanti saya akan upload dekat dalam Google Classroom. Okay, and then apa nama itu, make sure you write the question number 1 until 7. Then this one you biar je. Then question 1 and then for new question, you start with a new page. Okay. And then make sure sebelum you submit your answer or upload your answer, kalau you buat macam ni, okay, you boleh nampak you ada buat every question. Okay. So bila you masa you scan tu, make sure you memang ada 7-7 soalan. Okay. So kalau nak lagi memudahkan you supaya you tak ada tercicir, you buat je question 1, question 2, question 3, question 4, question 6, question 5, 6 and 7. So contohnya question 5 ni you tak sempat nak buat. So you just biar je kosong. Okay. Biar je page tu kosong. And saya pun tahu you memang tak jawab soalan 5. Bukannya you tertinggal. Okay. So nak selamat buat macam tu je lah. Okay. So saya tak nak nanti in case you dah submit, lepas tu baru you perasan, sorry ni saya terlupa nak scan satu page. So saya tak nak macam tu jadi lah. Okay, so make sure you check betul-betul you have all your answer, baru you upload. you punya answer dekat dalam Google Classroom. Okay. So mana yang ada problem in case hari tu tiba-tiba apa nama itu rumah rumah blackout ke, ke tak ada internet apa semua, so you kena guna data, apa data, so data lambat you nak upload dekat dalam Google Classroom, so tak ada masalah, you just hantar dekat saya through WhatsApp. Okay, so kalau you lambat nak upload markah, you tahu waktu tu hari kejadian tu memang you punya line slow, hujan ke apa ke, tak apa, tak ada masalah, you submit je guna WhatsApp. Okay, and then mana yang apa nama itu, mana yang nak guna selalu compile guna apa nama itu, small PDF ke apa. So kalau macam you nak mudah, you nak guna phone sahaja, you boleh download yang tu lah, apa apps dia, cam scanner tu. Yang tu you boleh guna phone, by phone. So you boleh just tangkap gambar, so dia akan compile all your answer, boleh juga. So mana yang nak guna cam scanner tu, yang guna phone tu, so untuk yang front page ni nak selamat, you print lah. You print and then nanti you tangkap gambar sekali je. Okay, in case nanti apa-apa jadi dekat hari kejadian, tak tahu kan. Okay, so itu adalah untuk nak submit. And then make sure bila you submit tu, you save you punya jawapan tu, you punya nama dulu, you punya full name. And then apa nama tu, student ID and then group. Okay, so nanti saya senang lah, saya susun you punya jawapan tu. Okay. So itu adalah untuk jawapan yang you nak upload hari Jumaat ni. And then untuk final assessment untuk Julai ni, I think nanti I just bagi dekat you jawapan, nanti you boleh check lah. Okay? So ada any questions tak before we end our class? So nanti you just tengok je lah every topic tu, you tengok balik apa yang you kena, apa yang highlight yang you kena ingat untuk setiap topik tu. Okay, so untuk yang topic 5, you just remember how to calculate and also how to interpret the value. And then untuk topic 4, you kena tengok macam mana, apa namanya tu, nak jawab untuk hypothesis testing, all the steps tu. Kalau guna p-value macam mana, kalau guna apa namanya tu, z-calculated macam mana, z-calculated macam mana, macam tu. Okay, and then ANOVA and also test of independence. Okay, then untuk confidence interval, just dapatkan lower and upper limit sahaja. So ada soalan nak tanya tak? Ada any questions?
Miss, saya nak tanya Miss. Hari Jumaat nanti petang kan? Pukul 2.45.
Betul. Hari Jumaat nanti 2.45 sampai 4.45.
Okay, thank you Miss.
Alright. And then lagi satu, nanti you punya soalan tu nanti dia akan dapat password tau. Lepas tu nanti I akan upload soalan tu 15 minit before, okay, before we start. So nanti untuk apa nama itu password pun saya akan bagi 15 minit sebelum lah. Okay, maybe answer script tu saya upload setengah jam sebelum lah. So nanti untuk password tu saya akan bagi 15 minit sebelum you jawab. So nanti you boleh tengok dulu soalan, okay, you boleh ni and then you can start lah. So you akan ada 15 minit sebelum and then saya akan bagi masa 15 minit selepas. So maksudnya contohnya you start 2.45 sampai 4.45. So make sure you dah habis jawab 4.45 tu. And then you ada 15 minutes, maksudnya dari 4.45 sampai pukul 5 tu untuk you upload your answer. So dalam masa 15 minit tu make sure kalau you ada apa-apa masalah, you bagitahu saya awal-awal. So macam saya kata, kalau tiba-tiba line you slow ke apa, you can submit your answer through WhatsApp. Okay, tak ada masalah. Okay, ada lagi tak nak tanya?
I'll show you how to.
Tak ada. Okay, so tak apa. You ada lagi apa 4 hari lagi untuk you nak study. Kalau in case you nak tanya apa-apa je, boleh tanyalah dekat dalam group ke, kat personal ke, tak kisah. Okay, and then untuk carry mark, so untuk carry mark sekejap saya akan bagi. Okay, nanti you check in case saya ada tersalah key in you punya apa markah tu, nanti you bagi tahu je saya. Alright. So nanti lepas kelas nanti saya akan bagi dekat dalam group lah. Right? So ada any questions before we end our class?
Dia ada soalan.
Tak ada.
Miss, nak tanya. I'll send something in the chat.
Okay, let's see.
Let's see. For question 7, February 2021.
Yep.
The last question, I think.
This one.
So let's say if I don't want to write the name of the variable multiple times, can I set a variable X to the variable of the study so that, you know, later on I don't have to repeat the same name over and over and just use X and Y?
Oh, maksudnya you let your X and Y before the question. Let
yes.
To ni. Actually, I lebih prefer you write there is a strong positive linear relationship between your X and also Y for each question. So,
okay, so you don't recommend doing the short way,
yes,
is it?
Yes.
Alright.
Kalau tengok apa namanya tu, kalau discuss every semester pun for common marking pun memang answer tu dia memang bagi macam ni lah. Dia tak ada buat yang macam tu. Yes, so saya tak prefer lah. Saya tak prefer dia macam tu. Right.
Alright, thank you.
Alright. Okay, ada lagi ni question. Okay, so kalau tak ada, thank you for today. So nanti apa namanya tu saya akan upload yang macam saya kata yang front page ni. Okay, so nanti saya akan upload dekat Google Classroom. And then make sure nanti bila you submit you punya answer, you ada front page yang ini, and then baru you punya answer, and then make sure you start a new question in new page. Okay, so nanti kalau ada anything update saya akan bagi tahulah. Right, so thank you for today. So nanti kalau ada any questions you can ask me later. Right, alright, thank you.
Okay, alright, thank you so much, Miss.
Thank you, Miss.